I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. I'm going to show you how to use the image stabilizer using this first establishing shot, which is this beautiful 20-foot crane shot. Unfortunately, the wind was blowing pretty hard, so if I play through this shot, you can see that even though I have nice smooth motion because of the camera support, the wind is introducing just a little bit of wobble to the scene. Fortunately, DaVinci Resolve has image stabilization, which is found inside of the tracker palette. There's a second mode of the tracker palette, the stabilizer. And I can use the stabilizer in this case to analyze the scene and get rid of any wobble that I don't like. First things first, I'm going to turn on loop. And another thing, you'll notice that the background is black. So I'm going to open up the settings, and inside of the project settings, I'm going to go to general options and turn on use gray background in viewers. Click apply. This lightens up the background. It's going to make it really easy for us to see what happens when we first apply stabilizations. Inside of the tracker palette, all I need to do is click the track forward button, and Resolve automatically analyzes the whole shot. The analysis shows up in this graph, and you can see that each line in this graph is color-coded to show you individual analyses for pan, tilt, zoom, and rotate, all of which I've analyzed. Going back to the very beginning of the shot, first you analyze, then you stabilize. When I click stabilize with the default settings and play through, you can see that I've gotten the wobble out, but I've done it in the most extreme way possible, with the default strong setting of 100 and smooth set to 0. Clicking the stabilize button basically tells Resolve to try and pin down the image. This is a little extreme. It's not quite what I want. So I'm going to use the strong and smooth controls to reintroduce some of that camera motion back into the shot while continuing to smooth things out. To make it a little easier to see what I'm doing, I'm going to press Command Plus to zoom into the frame, and I'm going to middle mouse click drag the frame over. Now the strong parameter is the parameter that dictates how much stabilization I want to add. If I double click this, set it to 0, and click the stabilize button again, I'm effectively eliminating the motion smoothing from the image. Let's do something a little bit different. Let's set strong to 90, and let's turn smooth all the way up to 99. Click stabilize, and now let's take a look at the motion. Now I've got more of that range of motion in the shot, but it's still smoothed, and you can manipulate both of these parameters to allow more or less of the original motion through into the shot. For example, I can lower the smooth parameter, click stabilize, and now I have a little more of the original stabilization data coming through. Or I could drop the strong parameter, click stabilize, and now I'm reintroducing just a little bit of the original wobble. So by manipulating both the strong and smooth parameters, you can try and find a happy medium between the original camera motion and the smoothed version of the camera motion that you're trying to achieve. If I reframe the entire shot, you can see that around the corners of the image, all of this smoothing is causing a little bit of geometrical shifting. Now, one way I can get rid of that is by turning on this zoom box. When I click stabilize, the image is automatically zoomed in to the point where any blanking that's introduced at the edges of the frame as a result of my motion smoothing is eliminated, except that I've got this letterboxing baked into the image. Fortunately, it's an easy thing to open up the sizing palette, and you can just manually zoom in. And now I've really got that nice smooth crane shot that I originally wanted. For more information about stabilization, tracking, and color grading in DaVinci Resolve, check out the Color Grading in DaVinci Resolve 11 title I did for Ripple Training. And stay tuned for more Resolve tips in under 5.